I'm walking down the street, and the street looks very crazy. There's a girl I'd like to meet, but she's not really living here. She dates back to Catherine, the one from the Medicis. She drinks liquor laced with poison since she went through all the six.
The street will die one day and fade away. The street will die one day and fade away.
Pendant la Fashion Week, il n'y a pas que des défilés et heureusement, je vous emmène ce matin pour une présentation pas comme les autres puisque nous avons le parfait petit déjeuner et le concert de jazz qui nous attendent pour l'interview exclusive de Johan Lindenberg.
How good?
Nice to
meet you.
See you in your store.
This is actually, I say, you know, I do the stores like I like to live, so it's more like my home.
It's totally like a big apartment.
Yeah, it's like a big apartment. It looks like my apartment at home as well, so.
But I like the fact that there is also a breakfast for a little bit more people than just you.
Yeah, we decided we need to do something different we want to do something different during Fashion Week. And Fashion Week is like every minute is occupied and everyone is doing so many things, but during breakfast I thought like it's kind of a different thing to do breakfast.
So explain to me a little bit the philosophy. So you wanted to create something like it's your apartment, but in Seoul,
no,
a little
I
bit
mean,
edgy.
I've been, I don't know, in my career, you know, I was with Diesel and I had for many, many, many years my own label under my own name, which I actually left in 2008, which was called J. Lindenberg. And then when I started this, and I worked with Justin Timberlake, as you know, because
we covered you, exactly.
Yeah, for 2 years, and then I decided I wanted to create something very, very personal. I went through a big separation after a long marriage, and I decided to, I'm going to use the energy of that separation to create something very personal, and I use a generic name.
Okay.
So Black Denim, is as a contrast to have my personal name on the label. So very generic name and make it more personal than ever. So basically menswear is inspired by my own wardrobe. The women's wear is exactly what I like to see on a woman. And like the stores, it's like I like to live. So.
Alors, let's talk about this, which is you know, probably the most appearing things in the store,
yeah.
And that was at Colette.
Yeah, but my philosophy when I started Black Denim was that I don't want to follow the traditional fashion rhythm.
Right.
I don't want to do theme collections, which means that every season you can come up with like a theme about tango in Argentina or English countryside or a French car or anything. So I felt like now I just want to do exactly what I like to wear myself or my friends around me or what I like to see on a woman.
So we're in the heart of Seoul and I can see that you really kept, you know, like the very high ceiling and the tags, and I mean, you can feel where you are.
You know, in my career, like I said, with Diesel, I was part of building a brand from Italy, with J. Lindenberg, a brand from Stockholm, with William Rast and Justin Timberlake, it was Los Angeles. I felt like now, I want to stay in New York forever. I want to be a full New Yorker. And so this is kind of a manifest of the things I've done during my career.
So why are you obsessed by New York now? Why do you want to become a New Yorker?
No, I came here already in 95, actually, the first time with Diesel. And then I lived 3 years. I moved back to Europe, to Milan, Stockholm. I came back, I stayed 2 years, and then I moved back again to London 5 years, and then I came back, and then I moved to LA, and then back. So it's the fourth time I'm coming back.
So now you're like, okay, I'm staying.
And I decided, now I stay forever. I don't move.
Okay.
And I think for me, New York is very, this is a town where I can express myself, I can be myself. It's also make me really live in the presence, because I've always been in the future somehow, but here it's so intense every minute. So it grounds me. It makes me live in the presence, which
That's
I think is
good.
Very nice.
That's very good. And when are we going to be able to cover you at a fashion show?
I don't want...
With your rent.
If I do a fashion show, it has to be a couture show, I think.
Excuse me.
I think it's the only thing that makes sense.
Bienvenue maintenant dans le showroom, là où les boutiques viennent pour découvrir la collection de l'année prochaine.
Yeah. And also, I do all my own photography.
Oh, I was wondering, because
everything.
I love your pictures of the way you presented them in the store.
I do everything myself, and actually I had, an incredible experience in Paris with Caroline Demaigret.
Yes.
Oh, I was there, we shot 2 days. It's something that I discovered also through Black Denim, to use the product to really explore new areas of creativity. And for me, I think it's it's a great challenge to be able to create a brand with pictures. And
totally, but I mean, that's what Karl Lagerfeld is like.
So I like 2-3 times a week I do shoots. Also tomorrow, full day shoot. So
the photographer. This is a sneak peek of the next collection.
Fall. It's fall 13.
So green and black, it's going to be hot next year.
This is a dusty pink. This is dusty pink.
That's exactly...
Okay, put this on your shoulders. If I put it on the shoulders, you're going to try it on. You just hang on the shoulders. I think it's very chic, like this. Look at that.
No, I know that I'm not.